Doing fine, girl. Steady on. Slow down now. Easy does it.
This way, my dear. I've something to show you. Hop in.
Where are we going?
One of Starik's workshops, where they build weapons for his army. When the world is full of nasty things, we must tear those things apart. Like Starik built a world around his own desires. And so we lose the ability to dream for ourselves. Therefore, we must
strike.
Precisely. No matter the cost.
What a funk in you.
You must see the potential, dear Jacob. This workshop is one of Starik's. Set the dynamite and let's blow it to atoms. Together.
Enough of you, boy!
What could be happening?
Not another step!
you over there.
Nothing's gonna slip past me.
I'll pummel you into orphan's gruel.
That's one. There. Set. Done.
I won't lose you this time. I won't let you out of my sights. Ready to shoot the airport.
All rigged up.
Perfect. Let's put our plan into action. Stand back. Ready?
Wait!
Whatever for?
There are children in there.
Jacob, my dear. Starrick uses child labor to manufacture goods. We must put an end to his production line.
But not like this.
Why not? I can do whatever I damn well please. Soon, you will understand what it is to be free, as I am. Light them up, boys!
No!
What the hell are you doing?
We're not playing games anymore, Roth!
No, we're not.
Mm-hmm.
you get. Move quickly. No time to idle.
A gift, sir, from Mr. Roth. You should be warned, Mr. Fry, that when Roth is angry with one, he generally brings suffering to many.
My dearest Jacob, alas, it seems our adventures together have come to a close. Although our time together was brief, it's left a lasting mark. I wish you well in all your future endeavors. Cordially, Maxwell. Postscriptum. I'm putting on a show this evening. All of London will be there. Enclosed, please find your invitation.
Indeed, sir.
Eliza, is that really you? Aren't these masks marvelous? What a splendid idea this is.
Absolutely.
But he's only
told you he's mad.
Did. No doubt about it.
It's a very odd title, my dear.
I believe the chorus is Latin.
Oh, yes, this way. I've never come to this play with that title before.
What do you suppose it's about? In ancient times, the crow was known to be a much like the fox.
Oh, Herman, you know everything, don't you?
Enter the theatre for tonight's performance.
There's nothing here for you.
Don't come any closer.
You have to make the big gestures for the people in the gallery. Otherwise, they can't see what's happening.
It's a bit more.
Thank you. I am delighted. To think of our performance will be
now the next step is to add Rob.
Everyone ready? Then let's proceed.
Mesdames et messieurs, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Alhambra Music Hall. Tonight, we have, for one night only, a very special performance of Corvus the Trickster. While some of the effects may be visceral and highly disturbing, do not be alarmed, my good people. Fear not. This is a purest form of entertainment. Tonight's performance immortalizes and is for the benefit of a young fellow very near and dear to my heart. Any concerns or complaints may be addressed to him. Jacob, dear boy, tonight is for you.
I'll be serving you this evening, gentlemen.
We're still here, love. Last time, I swear, you nearly poisoned us.
Scene two, stand by!
Let me out! I need to lower the grid for the show!
I ate this godforsaken job. I should be up there performing the mic.
We have a volunteer! A big round of applause for this brave, brave man! Our volunteer!
On stage like that.
You lucky people are about to witness this gentleman being fired upon at point blank range. Our performer will hit several targets placed around his head. Exciting, is it not? Oh, 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 oh. Will our honored guest go unharmed? We British are a hardy bunch. Let's put that hardiness to the test.
It's really as simple as...
Ah!
if he's not Roth?
Leaves a strange taste in your mouth, doesn't it? Like eating pork when expecting venison.
Excuse me, love. Just looking for the lavatory.
It's over there.
Thanks.
We found a suitably flat-headed gentleman for this one. You laugh, ladies and gentlemen, but I assure you that is the case. I have no doubt that you could hazard a guess as to what this one concerns, my friends. Our courageous participant hasn't even fled.
Stay in this city. Never would have happened in my father's day.
Standing a few feet away, our performer expertly throws his knives at the apple, slicing it in two. Willie or won't he?
Where is he?
The search consumes you. Creed forgotten, prey visualized, mouth watering.
Mr. Ross says he'll have me up there, on the stage before you know it.
Thank you. The flavor intensifies the second time. The hunt now a search for want rather than need.
You fucking Stand off!
I'll whip out your inner
bloody neck!
Hey, don't scare me!
Roth! Show yourself!
I hope you have enjoyed your evening so far, ladies and gentlemen. I know I have. Now, before our final act, I would like to toast all you brave people who joined us tonight to celebrate life and death. Go on! Toast them! Your move, Jacob, my dear! Burn! 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 Jacob, my dear!
The Daisy, Tom Wuchler.
Of legends.
Why did you do it? All of it.
What? Snap a baby crow's neck between my thumb and forefinger. Slice to bits the ones you deem innocent. Keep the world in its divine manic state. For the same reason I do anything. Why not?
I'll never make it out alive. Damn this place from hell to Hackney.
widespread disorder. The sea rises to flood the pubs and extinguish the street lamps. Our city will die. Tupine has failed. Lucy has failed. Brudenell, Elliotson, Pearl. All have gone into the night. It is up to me now. The assassins have brought nature's fury into our homes. Men have become monsters, barreling toward us, teeth out. Our civilization must survive this onslaught. To prevent a return of the Dark Ages, I will start anew. London must be reborn.
The Peace of Eden is under Buckingham Palace. We've got all we need. Let's start planning our infiltration.
Hold on, better to get visual verification. If we're gonna move, we need to be 100% sure. We'll only get one shot before Otso Berg crashes down on us.
Gotta agree with Sean.
We'll position ourselves near the palace. But we'll wait for you to sync the genetic data before we move.
It's all up to you, Initiate.
You're late. Starrick is making his move. The Peace of Eden is somewhere inside Buckingham Palace.
Let him have it.
I've seen your handiwork across the city. Perhaps you should trust my judgment.
I've been killing Starrick's henchmen. What have you been doing? Let's ask Henry, shall we?
I have been repairing your mistakes. Too much haste is too little speed.
Don't you quote father at me.
That's Plato. And I am sorry, this doesn't involve anything you can destroy. Father was right, he never approved of your methods!
Father is dead!
Enough! I have just received word from my spies. At the palace ball tonight, Starrick plans to steal the Peace of Eden, and then eliminate all the heads of church and state.
Once more for old time's sake?
And then we're finished.
Agreed. So what's the plan?
Such an unexpected delight to visit you both. What is the news on the street?
Mrs. Disraeli, we have discovered that there is something inside Buckingham Palace that could threaten the...
What my sister's failing to say is that we require entrance into the ball tonight.
Impossible! Even if there were any invitation cards remaining, which there are not, someone of your lowly station...
If that damn fool Gladstone is attending this evening, they can have my card. Perfect. Then I'll go alone.
Mrs. Disraeli, if you'd be kind enough to inform my darling brother of the location of the Gladstone's residence, perhaps he could use his considerable skills to commandeer their cards.
What fun! Did you hear that, Dizzy? We're going to pinch the Gladstone's invitations.
Thank you for volunteering me, sweet sister.
Oh, a pleasure, brother, dearest. Now, Mrs. Disraeli, if you would excuse me, I must visit with the Maharaja. It occurs to me that he may have a second set of plans to a certain vault.
The
nerve of Evie.
Treating me like a child.